the tour. Because we saw the other side of it when we went in.
Yeah.
Because we knew then we were outside. We were outside there, obviously. Yeah.
Attention to the activities outside of the committee where dates have been included for the work
so the people on doesn't drive and a little closer, it's called Keep Me Up. They have been there a long time and their children have played on this. They thought there was a covenant already in place. But there also, what doesn't show on your map here, there is a public footpath through, now I assume you know how popular Claremont Farm is these days. You can go through Claremont Farm and it's a similar distance, but that is private land. This is a public footpath that allows people access. That's one consideration. The other consideration is its designation in the local plan. I did have an email from Stephen Warren, and I did have an email from Keith Cleary about this urban green space. And so really I just want some reassurance around the existing covenant, if they could check that, the footpath and people's rights on that, and also the designation of the local plan when we're not at Reg 19 yet.
Thanks. I do actually have Steve around with it. I'll endeavour to answer your question and put Steve in his call for him. Yes, the most important thing about going into a disposal is to do a full check on the due diligence really with all the legal matters. There is no defence if you sell a site without the knowledge of a covenant, so we have to explore that fully and our legals to check that and even take out assurance about disposals, protection about any future covenants or restrictions that we haven't managed to alert. So we'll cover that. In relation to the site specifics, I'm not fully aware of all the details, but certainly any site that is in line with our Brownfield First strategy and our emerging planning policy and the requirements protection of public of open space will be fully reflected in their disposal terms and conditions.
Thank you. So it might come back to us if we do go to exec session, because I would be keen if we could follow up on the two previous David's comments around potential optionalness.
Communities and social value, and you can't always just measure things. had some sort of correspondence, I would say, about how that would be, that the tunnels would also protect this side, what we've got on the information here. I'm sorry, I can't mention the past, it's a bit...
Okay, could I deal with the agricultural land first? And you make a point,
sorry.
Yeah, you deal with the agricultural land. Yes, it does appear that if you're selling a freehold, something you own, a future
combined value of all these assets is considerably more than what we are seeking to raise. So we do have that space, and they should be considered in due time. While at the same time, we can meet the deadline we set ourselves to raise the funds in line.
Okay, I've got Joe and then Phil. I just want to, before bring Joe in, sorry, Harry, did you indicate?
Yeah, we'll give you questions.
Okay, thanks. Sorry, before bringing colleagues in, I think, you know, it's been emphasised the financial situation of the council directive that we've got to repay that as well. We've got ambitious regeneration programmes that we need to deliver as well. But just as important as all of that, we have a local plan, and that's ongoing, and that needs to, we need to show commitment to demonstrate that we are prepared to protect our rebuild and to have a brownfield first policy, which we all, as elected members, agree to. So, whilst I appreciate some members may not be happy with the speed at which this is being presented here tonight, but time is of the essence, because we need to demonstrate with regard to swallow the plan and to be able to sell off the assets to repay capitalisation directive. So we need to be mindful of that. A few members have started to name specific sites. So after I bring Joe and Phil in, I'm minded to go through the list of sites, and we can then either agree or disagree on those sites that we're happy to progress with, the ones that were not, we can follow, and then make a decision what we're going to accept to discuss them in more detail. Well, bring Joe and Phil.
Thanks, Chair. Obviously, I support the decision to repay the capitalisation loans and to sell assets in order to do that. I think broadly, there's more than enough assets that are no longer needed by the council that could be sold to the repayments of the loans, probably even double that. We've got a lot of headroom. And one of the things this policy, the report doesn't mention, is the council's existing policy on community asset transfer. It's part of the asset transfer policy, it's priority four, and it fits in with what Councillor Williamson was saying about balancing financial needs and social needs. You can count the value of things in pounds, but how do you count a young person learning to read, a family receiving food that needs it, a warm hug for an elderly and lonely person? These things are very difficult to count, but they're part of the Wirral plan, they're part of what we're here to do. And a real good example of that is from the Civic Centre. There's a long history of community support from the Wirral Civic Centre. I'm sad to say opposition by Wirral Council to that. In the last few years alone, there's been petitions signed by thousands of local residents, there's been motions at full council, there's been debate at Policy and Resources Committee and other committees, there's been a play, press articles, it was a key local election issue. And unlike any other asset on the list to be disposed of, this site already has two credible assessed community asset transfer business plans. And selling Bromham Civic Centre at best value would be contrary to the expressed wishes of Bromham's community, its elected representatives, and the Tourism Community, Cultures and Leisure Committee. It's a very divisive proposal that damages the council's relationship with its communities across the world. You've clarified there's no risk of a Section 141 bankruptcy kind of notice that other sites could be sold. So could you please provide a credible answer about why Bromham Civic Centre is included for decision today rather than after the community asset transfer process is completed?
Okay, thank you.
Yes, I think mine is more of a comment, Chair, if I may. As it seems to me, and David, when you outline the reason for it, suggesting there's some sort of wicked plot to demand money with medicines, where in fact this is about repaying. You know, we ran, council ran out of money, we were going to get pushed, we had to go to the government, and the government said, you know, we're not just going to chip money into a black hole. If you want this, it comes with certain conditions. One of those conditions was it would be repaid, it would be repaid over a particular time frame, and it would be repaid by us actually selling property or disposing of property that we don't have an overriding need for as a council. Yeah. And I think that's the position we're in. I think even last year when I was not as involved in all this as others were, everybody knew that a list was being put together of those properties that were going to need to be disposed of to raise the money. It's now saying, oh gosh,